after the mine closed down in 1903, this chamber lay silent until World War II, when the Royal Navy at Plymouth requisitioned it to store their rum here, a much safer place in Plymouth, which was heavily bombed. Whenever they hid the rum, in various locations around the British Isles, they also hid the national treasures too, such as the crown jewels and the valuable artworks and artifacts from museums and art galleries. We call this chamber the rum store in honour of its use back then, and in 2002, converted it into a 450-seat auditorium. It's very atmospheric venue and has an excellent natural acoustic, but it's always 10 degrees, so our audiences need to dress warmly and bring a cushion to sit on. The Cathedral Chamber Landing. The Cathedral Chamber was once backfilled too, to the level you are now standing on. Having backfilled the chamber, by the time they worked the ceiling at this height, they then removed large quantities of rubble, initially to extend further back under the hill, where better quality slate had been found, where two lit footpaths became one leading deeper under the hill. And then later, in the 1930s, for use as hardcore when someone of the country lanes in this area were being surfaced. It was lit by 5 candle power light bulbs, and if you stare hard into the shadows, you can just about see the team of 3 men at the rock face, one of whom is holding the drill bar. You really would not want this job. In fact, this job was often given to a lad of about 14 years old, a son or a nephew of one of the men with the sledgehammers, on the grounds that they would take more care of their fingers than they would of someone not related to them. Is this an early form of health and safety, perhaps? It seemed to work well, since the older ones would often be too old and arthritic to work by around 35 years old. After that, they'd be relying on him to earn a living to look after them. He was, in fact, in that pension fund. The blasting was done at the end of the working day, so the blocks and dust would settle overnight, and because coordinated blasting made the workplace an altogether safer place.
Spooky.
It's rumoured that they used to carry water out in billy cans they used to bring their food in for the day. Their food was often referred to as crib or croust, usually a traditional Cornish pasty with meat at one end and fruit pudding at the other. Crib, I don't know, that's where it came from.
Is it?
Yeah, it's just
in it. Curdo!
The food was often referred to as crib.
The old cribbage! It's fucking crib time! Look at that open sea. Whoa. That's so cool.
Look at that. Look at that.
That is incredible. That is amazing. What a view. No way. That is awesome. Tell you what, there's some waves coming in now, Tom.
Yeah.
Look at these ones here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh my god, look at that. I don't want to fall off this cliff. Not today. Look at that.